वेलकम स्टूडेंट, दिस इज योर सिविक्स क्लास 7 चैप्टर 2। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस क्वेश्चन आंसर ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। क्वेश्चन नंबर 1। इन दिस चैप्टर यू हैव रीड दैट हेल्थ इज अ वाइडर कॉन्सेप्ट दैट इलनेस। ऑब्जर्व दिस क्वोट फ्रॉम द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन एंड एक्सप्लेन द टर्म्स लिविंग स्टैंडर्ड एंड पब्लिक एंड इन योर वर्ड्स। Solution. Answer. Living standard means an individual level of living. People living in hygienic condition and enjoying all the comforts of life are said to be leading a high standard of living. On the other hand, people who live in unhygienic filthy places and drink polluted water and eat unhygienic food are said to lead a low standard of living. Public health is defined as the science of protecting and improving the health of people and their communities. It is achieved by providing quality health care service, either free or at a low cost, so that even the poor can seek treatment. Another important function of public health is to take action to prevent a spread of vital diseases like as TB, malaria, jaundice, cholera, etc. Question number 2. What are the different ways through which the government can take steps to provide health care to all? Discuss. Solution. The government can take the following steps to provide health care to all. Spreading health care awareness among common people through different means like workshops, seminars and training camps. 2. Increasing the number of health care centers, hospitals and family welfare centers. Organizing free health checkup camps for general public, organizing pulse polio and other similar special campaign, keeping a check on the service provided by doctors, nurses and other staff of the government hospital. Question number 3. What difference do you find between private and public healthcare service in your area? Use the following table to compare and contrast these. Private, very expensive. Availability of service, all the healthcare service are easily available. Public, either free or at very low cost. Availability of service, all the healthcare service may or may not be available all the time. If available, special services are not properly maintained. Moreover, due to the rush of people, these services are not adequate for large number of patients visiting such a hospital. 4. Improvement in water and sanitation can control many diseases. Explain with the help of example. Answers. Polluted water is a major cause of many communicable diseases like cholera, typhoid and jaundice. Similarly, poor sanitation causes spread of many epidemic like plague, dengue, malaria, etc. Provision of clean drinking water, maintaining cleanliness and proper disposal of waste can help to improve the situation. For example, we often see the spread of dengue and malaria in highly polluted cities like Delhi due to faulty waste management practices in the city. Both dengue and malaria are caused by the mosquito breeding on stagnant water of poorly maintained lakes and canals. Situation can be controlled by drinking the canals and cleaning the lakes with the help of sewage treatment plants and solvent. This is the end of this video. We will continue the next chapter in next video. If you have any doubt, please let us know. We will try to clear your doubts in another video. अगर आपको कोई संदेह है तो कृपया करके हमें बताइए, हम अगले वीडियो में आपके संदेह को दूर करने का प्रयास करेंगे।